trust me, I never punch as many people as I get credit for. The biggest thing was, I didn't take any crap off of anybody. I mean, you're not gonna back me in a corner and back me down. My dad never took any crap off of anybody. He used to tell me, he says, if you start a fight when you go to school, you're gonna get your butt kicked when you get home. If you walk away from a fight, you're gonna get your butt kicked when you get home. So I had no choice but to defend myself. Not necessarily start it, but I had to defend myself. Art Whipple came up. He bought Richard Schroeder's Camaro, funny car. And I didn't want anything to do with funny cars. I'm a dragster guy.
Is it true that you looked at funny car drivers as nothing more than horse jockeys that ran the Kentucky Derby? That level of toughness?
Well, yeah, they were too prim and proper, I guess you might say. I mean, not that we were dirty, but I mean, they're all, you know, got all of their nice stuff. And I mean, I like nice stuff, but I mean, I work on the race car and I'm going to get dirty. And those guys are a bunch of wusses.
Mcculloch dropping out of drag racing for a couple of years, back in it again at the start of this season.
Until Don Perdomo came along, there was no bigger name in AA fuel funny car racing than Ed the Ace Mcculloch from Fresno, California.
And then the sponsorship started to come. When the corporate sponsorship started to come, now I'm in your corporate apparel and you can't do things, and you can't say things, and you just can't have. So the fun, when the money came, the fun left. But when it went out there and when I hit John, I spun around, I can remember being upside down on the guardrail going backwards. So it spun around and I mean, I'm upside down. I remember saying, something's gonna hurt real bad. I'm extremely proud of the fact that I've won Indy 5 times in funny car. I won it top fuel. The majority of people don't look at Indy today the way we always looked at Indy as being what it was. When I was crew chief, even, I mean, when we'd start getting closer to Indy time, I mean, the guys, I used to tell the guys, and they'd say, what's the matter with you? I mean, you're all edgy. He says, listen, we're going to Indy. This is Indy. Do you know what Indy is? Yeah, it's another drag race. I said, no, it's not.
And a bit of a hole shot, it appears, for Ed Mcculloch. And unless something goes wrong, Ed Mcculloch wins it. 6.27 seconds.
Doing very well. Both cars completed their burnouts, now staging. Let's watch. A tremendous blower explosion for Ed Mcculloch. And Pat Foster crossing the center line, that will disqualify him. But let's look at Ed Mcculloch. He apparently is okay, but the car severely damaged.
With a guy that has a reputation of being in dire need of anger management back in the day, how does one simply decide I'm not that guy? How does that happen?
A time, I guess. I mean, I don't know when you become mature. It's certainly not 21.
Here's our winner, Ed Mcculloch, removing his fire mask here. He's going to be a mighty happy guy when it comes up.
Your winner.
And a happy greeting.
Good job, Eddie.